speak with them with a kind of voice. I was speaking to a father who felt really, how do I say, he was very judgmental of himself. He was talking about how when he had his first child, he was feeling, how do I say, jealous of that child. Here he was, he used to spend time with his wife, they can go date, and you know, then go on dates, and spend time together, and he is the apple of her eye, but as soon as baby comes in the picture, then the mom has to take care of her, and he's seeing her hold her and kiss her all the time, and he's saying, hey, what about me? So I heard this husband talking about that and really feeling judged. Maybe I'm a bad father. Maybe I'm selfish because I'm feeling jealous of my child. Maybe I'm because I feel a little envious. Maybe I'm not a good father. And I told him, you know what? It's important to allow yourself to be human. All fathers feel that. At some point in our lives as fathers, we feel, I wish I could get a little more attention from my wife. You know, dads, I see you laughing, so you can't hide it from me. But it's so important that we allow ourselves to feel that. Okay, we have those emotions. That's fine. But let us not move. Let us not act on those emotions. Let us not take them into, you know, trying to separate our child from our from the mother. Let us not do those kind of things. But let us acknowledge that we're human. Allow ourselves to have the permission to feel those emotions. Not start condemning ourselves. It's very important that when these negative emotions come up, when anger, these powerful emotions, when a little bit of envious feeling, you know, with the kids come up, it's important to learn how to work with them. It's important to learn how to use them, how to be in work with them. And it's important that when they come up, not to necessarily converse with them. You know, you'll see in this next picture that when a negative emotion comes up, it's really saying to you, oh, you know, you really are not a good daddy. How can you be jealous of your children? They're only two months old. How could you be so jealous? How old are you? You're 30 plus years old, 40 years old, and you're only thinking about yourself? Don't get into dialogue with that thing. Don't start saying, I know, I'm so terrible. I really am kind of selfish. Yes, I know you are selfish. You know, you should really be repenting more. Oh, yeah, I know. I can't get out of that. It's just over. You see? We don't want to get into dialogue with that. Once we start creating the common base, once we start creating common base and start giving and receiving with this particular type of emotion, then we allow it to start overcoming us. Then we start allowing it to overpower us. Here, take a look at this picture. It's kind of like this. When these negative emotions come up, they're going to be trying to tempt us into getting into a common base with them. They're going to be trying to say, come, make a common base with me so I can give and take with you. They're going to want to do that with us. It's very important that when we have these negative emotions, we allow ourselves to have them. We don't deny that they're there. We allow ourselves to have them, but not necessarily start giving and taking with them. It's important to sometimes just watch them. Watch it come. Watch it trying to tempt you, saying, talk to me. You are a bad parent. Talk to me. You know, you are neglecting your spouse. Talk to me. You're neglecting your children. When it says those kind of things, just watch it. Just watch it. And just don't give and take with it. Let it just use its energy. What you'll find is that emotion will become weaker. As you do not create a common base with it, you will not allow it to move into give and receive action with you. As it cannot move into give and receive action with you, that emotion has absolutely no power over you. So it's important to allow yourself not to start condemn yourself as soon as you have it. Just seeing it, keep yourself distant, put it in a little box, a nice box like that, a nice little box. You know, don't let it come and talk to you. Don't let it come and try to tempt you to just talk to it and converse with it and remind yourself how bad you are. But just, you can watch it. You can see it getting weaker and weaker. And as you do that, it will gently pass. It will gently move away. It's almost like being a doctor who's watching the patient. Not necessarily giving and taking with that patient, but observing it. Watching, seeing what are the symptoms, what are the things that it's doing, what are the things that that patient is doing. In the same way, as those emotions come, we don't have to deny them. We don't have to condemn ourselves for having them, but we don't have to necessarily create a common base with them. It's so important that when it's in that drive to try to connect with us, that we start separating ourselves, that we don't let these emotions overpower us. And really, when we think about it from a principal perspective, this was really the problem of the fall. Lucifer, problem with him, not the problem was not that he felt emotion. The problem was not that he had a powerful emotion. Because any elderly son or elderly child may feel envious of their younger children. But the point was not that. The point was that he started to dialogue with that in his mind. He started to say, yeah, wait a minute, that's right. God loves them more than me. He doesn't love me as much. And he started to get into conversation with that. And that allowed it to get stronger. That allowed the common base with that emotion to get stronger. And the give and receive to get stronger. And that is a problem that led to the fall. It's so important that when we analyze this from our own lives, that we learn to not judge ourselves so heavily for having the emotion. The emotion itself is not the problem. It's the emotion that we start giving and receiving with that influences our action that is the problem. So it's important to, at times we have good days, we have bad days as human beings. It's important to let ourselves have the permission to do so. To have the good days, to have the bad days as well. To feel the ups and downs of life. But not necessarily be controlled by those ups and downs.